Hello everybody, welcome back to the One Nation of Gamers Summer Circuit Feature Tournament number 4. The fourth and final feature tournament of the Summer Circuit. We are one match away from finding out the eighth and final player that will be heading to the Grand Finals at PAX to compete for 230 World Championship points and $25,000. Once again, I'm TJ, joined by Trump. Trump, this is going to be sort of the conclusion of the Summer Circuit. The only event that 4-0 OG Summer Circuit that will happen after this is the Grand Finals. So it's about to come to a close. Chalky versus Darts. Based off the lineups, who's taking it all, Trump?
All right, well, these lineups are actually extremely similar. Chalky with the Freeze Mage is probably the thing to look out for. Turns out that Darts Rogue is not going to do too well against Chalky, I believe, because Chalky's not bringing that... basically, the decks that are really strong against, really weak against Rogue, like Paladin, for example. So, when it comes down to Freeze Mage versus Rogue, I believe Chalky's lineup ends up being a bit better.
Yeah, Chalky is going to throw out the Handlock first. Dart's going to throw out the Hunter. So, off the bat, Chalky goes into a little bit of an unfavorable matchup in this game. Still not impossible. He does find a pretty decent early start with a lot of Taunt Givers, at least.
That's right. Against Facehunter, you are looking for three key things: Taunt Givers, Molten Giants, and Healbots. And Chalky has two of those things, but this is not a Facehunter. It's more of a mid-range hunter, in which, well, a hybrid hunter with that golem there. And
ooh,
he now has all of those three, but that's not a guaranteed win against a mid-range hunter. But it's certainly a good place to be.
He has the Handlock Exodia against aggressive decks. Taunt Givers.
That's right.
Moltons.
And not to mention, he had that Ancient Watcher Sun Fury start as well. At this point, what Chalky would like to complete the set would be something to play on 4. It could be as simple as Owl Tap, though.
Yeah. He would be getting a little bit low, but, I mean, that's what the Molten Giant Healbot is for. Mountain Giant is not something that he's going to be able to play, so Tap Owl it is. Hellfire is another good card. It allows him to clear the board and play Molten Giant on the same turn. If we get later in the game, also, it could allow for something like Hellfire Molten Giant Healbot, which is a pretty big swing turn. But this is a lot of damage.
That's not necessarily good. So, Dart's got to make a tough choice here. Do you set the opponent down to 11? If you do, you might immediately lose the game, or you might win the game.
So, if he sets him down to 11,
his nightmare Chalky would be multiple molds. Sundry.
Then Chalky's dead, because Dart has Arcane Golem. He'd be at 8 with no heal. But Dart is scared of the Molten Sun Fury. Once Sun Fury has been played, I think I'd make this attack. And I think that is just going to be the game.
Certainly not over yet. Do Molten and Defender of Argus. And that looks like it blocks the Arcane Golem and the Huffer. And then...
Nope, he's dead. A quick game one.
Oh, that's a bold way to play it. Let's see. Yeah, okay. The other one loses to Owl, so lose the one or the other.
Yeah. This way sets you up for the best possible turn later on. Chalky, probably not too phased by that one. It is a rough matchup. He did have a good hand, but Dart going for the calculated risk of pushing in with the Huffer, and he's going to take a quick lead and this final matchup with a game number one victory.
That's right. It looked like he just darted ahead there.
It's too bad there's no Chalky puns. Chalky's name is too unique, I suppose. Chalky still...
I have a chock full of them.
Keep it going, Trump. How many puns can you fit in by the end of this broadcast?
I think I just ran out. All right, so okay. We have Freeze Mage against Rogue, which is pretty even, I'd like to say. Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say so. Rogues, if given the time, can make really big turns.
I don't know if that's a overlay strangeness, but did Chalky just keep Flame Strike? No, that can't possibly be true.
Yeah, I don't think it is. But we'll get his hand back in just a second. It looks like we had a little bit of a spectator error, so we'll be jumping back into the spectate mode in just a second. Chalky picks up the... He might have thrown away something and got a Flame Strike. I don't know if he would keep it. Maybe, though.
Okay, a smooth opening from Chalky's side. He got to draw cards on three. He gets to deal with a low threat here. Looking at the Freeze Mage hand, you can generally tell what's going through their mind or what their future is. He really wants to draw cards, and the only way he can is Thalnos, so... puts it out there.
He's going to go with the Frostbolt as well. Chalky has a lot of his burn in his hand already. Pyroblast, double Frostbolt, and Fireball. Dart, basically what he wants right now is just creatures. He just wants to apply as much pressure as possible. And if given the time, he's going to be looking to just find a big oil turn. Put on the pressure early and just find a big oil turn. And Chalky feels threatened enough to... go ahead and fireball this down on turn 5 instead of going for like Acolyte of Pain ping. Feels really threatened by the rogue.
Yep, makes sense. That's one of the cards that basically just keeps on coming. So Chalky right now, it's in a reasonable spot. The pressure hasn't been a lot. Darts hand has two saps, which is awkward because sap is bad in this matchup. He's got the sprint, but he's kind of getting bogged down by the two saps, actually, because it's actually difficult to spend the cards. Backstab finds a pretty good purpose here with the Azure Drake helping. Might just try to burn the saps. That's pretty good. No other real way to use it.
Yeah, very true. He's going to sort of go into a Flame Strike here. He'll still be left with a creature from the Piloted Shredder. In fact, Chalky may opt to go for a Frost Nova Doomsayer Loot Hoarder, which looks to be the play. And that way he opens himself up for a better Flame Strike. And Dart looks like he probably is going to use the second sap to protect his creatures here. Does he have a way? It's sort of hard to see his cards because they're overlapping each other, but...
Yeah, I mean, he could consider the backstab while he's got a lot of cards as well. That would be three from the backstab, two from the fan, and then possibly a deadly poison. But instead, he chooses to use the sap.
Yeah.
One of Dart's puzzles right now, kind of a mini puzzle in this game, is how can he spend his cards so that he can sprint and not overdraw. With 7 cards in hand, and he's going to draw one into 8, he can't really just sprint because then he would overdraw by 1 and then he would also need to play cards. I guess what he's looking for is preparation.
Yeah, Chalky doing a little bit of quick counting with his cards, realizing that he can afford to play Acolyte of Pain and ping it this turn. Because even if he dart attacks in twice, he won't overdraw. He'd be at 10 cards. He'd draw his 10th card going into his next turn. So always something that you want to keep in mind. You have some very key cards to victory in this deck. A couple of them being cards like Archmage Antonitis and Alexstrasza that you can't really afford to have burn. So you really need to count your cards when you play Acolyte of Pain to make sure that you're not going to be overdrawing something important.
Yep, Dart finds a way to draw cards, plays the... Deadly Poison, and then that, and he has a way out with the coin, and then one more thing, perhaps the South Sea Deckhand. But perhaps keeping the South Sea Deckhand is important in order to get that guaranteed charge at the end while your board is frozen. But he has the one mana spare, so he's like, he still has to make a decision, though. This is not as obvious as it looks. That's why he hesitated. Can be useful in order to get a guaranteed oil.
Yes.
You may find later on that he'll have no way to apply an oil. But even if he doesn't find a way to apply an oil, right now by playing this card, it's adding in the 2 damage. But yeah, he misses the 3 from the oil. It's a tough decision.
Yeah. But Chalky, definitely getting deeper into his deck here, has a clean board. He hasn't taken too much damage, still at 20 health. 20 health is something that is feasible for a rogue to just be able to do in one turn.
It is. Perhaps more important is that Dart has managed to get in attacks with minions, and it looks like this Lotheb is going to guarantee a 9. Well, not guarantee, because he's played this Lotheb a bit too late for Frost Nova to get completely locked out, and Frost Nova to block 9 is pretty good. But Dart, Chalky does not have it.
He does have Healbot, which is about the best thing he could ask for when a Lotheb is played, if you don't have a free spell like Frost Nova that's cheap. So,
and that is the best thing you can play, but he isn't reducing like combo pieces with Antonitis, but still. He also has to just think about, am I about to get popped with the block? That's 12 opposing damage. And with a hand that size and no eviscerates played so far, I think he's afraid of dying, which means anti-killbot could be critical in making sure he gets another turn.
Yeah. Ice Barrier also serves the same purpose, but he's definitely going to want to save that for when it's cheaper to fit it in. He's thinking about it, though. That's interesting. He moused over it. Anti-Killbot seems like a much better choice. Sort of the same effect, but...
Right, since the Scientist also gets an Ice Barrier. Unless he's played one?
No, he's played one Ice Barrier. So the Scientist isn't going to pull anything.
Yeah, but it's a 2-2.
Unless the block is popped. There's oil. All right,
draws into some good stuff there. A full hand from the rogue. Manages to find an oil while he has the minion, so Dart's got to be pretty anxious to play that. Unfortunately, only has a one-charge weapon, but still good enough. Not to mention, you get a really big Edwin Van Cleef.
He's just going for it, I guess.
How many cards do I want to backstab? 0.
Twelve! Oh, man. Chucky actually has a lot of damage in his hand, but just not really enough time to use it.
This is actually frightening from... Chalky has the Blizzard Doomsayer, and that's going to be... When I look at Dart's hand, I'm like, oh man, how does he deal with that? He has the 3 from the backstab, the 2 from the agent, but...
He could deal with it, but he would have to use a Blade Flurry.
Yeah, ugh.
Or an oil. You could dagger up oil, or dagger up blood mage oil, backstab hit.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense, since it also deals, it actually deals 9 damage to face. In which case, you probably would rather just pop the block. Wait, no, because you don't have the mana. So I guess you have to just deal 9 damage to face and not pop the block.
Gonna give Chalky a little bit of breathing room. But not much. Alright, so he puts him at 1.
Yep. Chalky's gonna be on a very tight schedule from here on out. But he has managed to draw the Alexstrasza. But usually you would need 3 turns after the Alexstrasza. And Chalky's going to have a tough time finding the 3 wins. Alexstrasza yourself is pretty much out of the question because there's such a high attack value around the opponent's side. It's not like you can freeze the board, so it looks like Chalky's line might have to be exactly Alexstrasza and then draw into Ice Block. And while throwing the burn and then throwing the pyroblast, but Dart's got the counter to that in Heelbutt.
He could fireball the Edwin, frostbolt the Lotheb, ping off the Paladin Shredder, and then next turn defensively Alexstrasza himself and hope that Dart runs out of damage.
Okay, yeah. By doing the Ice Lance on the Edwin Van Cleef, he was actually setting up to do that.
So there is a chance, but Dart has so much direct damage in his hand, I just don't think there's a way that Chalky comes back at this point. It's really tough. Next turn, if he defensively Alexstrasza's, Dart will still have more than enough damage to make it happen. So I think that is going to lock up the game. I don't see a way that Chalky wins this.
Yeah, but I like that way. One of the ways you can win this matchup is to clear the board first and then defensively Alexstrasza yourself. But in this case, Dart just had too much power on the board. What really pushed Dart ahead is he managed to find attacks with a lot of his minions, and he managed to guarantee a 9 damage attack with Lotheb also. And he managed to get an 8 damage attack in with minions without a Lotheb.
Yeah. So it looks like Chalky's only play to survive is Alexstrasza's own face, but we know that'll be certain death for him. He can flame strike Ice Barrier and hope there's no direct damage, but if he's keeping track, which he should be, he knows that there's still 2 of his straights plus an SI agent left, which Dart both has in his hand. And he goes ahead and concedes, and Dart takes a 2-0 lead in this series. Game face on for both players. Dart knows he's just 2 game wins away from making it to the grand finals at PAX.
Yep. Really big deal. Just 2 games away from such a grand event. $25,000 on the line if he makes it when he competes at PAX.
And also world championship points, which Dart is actually in the running. So is Chalky. So both these players have a lot on the line. They're actually pretty close in points. Chalky has 81, sitting currently at 18th, and Dart has 71, sitting currently at 23rd. So both these players really want to get to that top 8 sweet spot, and both of these players, with a trip to PAX, have a chance to get in the top 8. Neil Billy now is number 8 with 146 points, so both these players with 100 points, which would be the prize for first place at PAX, would put them into the top 8.
Right. For these players, the stakes are so high this match. Not only do you win this one and you get a good amount of cash for that, you get an entry into PAX, which might therefore then propel you into the Hearthstone World Championship. Big stuff.
Yeah, and like you mentioned, there's money on the line for this too. For 3rd and 4th place, which was Soundstorm and Strifeco, they got $750. 2nd place is $1,500, and 1st place is $3,000 for this match. So, they're playing for basically an extra $1,500 also on top of all the other things that we just mentioned. So Jockey, he's on the ropes now, down 2-0. Can he find a win with his Hunter against Darts Patron Warrior?
Yep, he's got to be very sad about this hand. You don't want to see the spells early. Oh, Dart goes with the Tempo Commander, and Chalky's actually pretty happy to see that because he didn't have a good play, and he was going to probably have to either just pass or coin Handmaster, but now he actually has the comfort to like just spend 3 mana on a kill command, and that's fine. Dart's probably happy at that because he's like, ha! I prevented Chalky from playing something on this turn.
Interesting that he went for the kill command as opposed to the quick shot. I suppose quick shot is more flexible as the game goes on. Kill command has the potential to be more damage, but for more mana.
Yep, quick shot might draw a card.
That's also true as well. Alright, coin Lothab it is. It interrupts his coin Savannah High main play, but he really needs to just apply pressure, and Houndmaster is not really that much pressure.
Yep, by coin Lothabbing also, you deny the opportunity to use one of those cheap one mana spells like Execute, which would have been pretty big on the Lothem, which is the biggest card of Hunter that Chalky's running, other than High main, but High main comes with its own issues. Some people might have Hunter's marked the Armorsmith there, and I'm sure there was some thought into that.
Yeah. Maybe if he was more aggressive Hunter. Ooh, Kill Command is a pretty decent pickup, but he has to think about how he's going to go about the turn. He ends up just Hunter's marking it this turn, which now it is going to gain 2 armor, whereas last turn if he had Hunter's marked it would have only gained 1. But at least he's able to sort of save his Mad Scientist as well. Start putting on the pressure, and
yeah, this moving is a good in amount for a next pressure.
Turn high main.
Sets up very well. Like 6 high main is good enough on an empty board, but 6 high main on a board that you're winning, that's good.
That's really good.
In Dart World, we have an Inner Rage, which doesn't look like it's going to accomplish much. You might have to use it. In fact, he drew another one, so the chances that he uses it in order to clear a 1 health minion have just gone up by a lot. He has the combo pieces of Commander and Frothing Berserker, but that's long term. His Battle Rage, which is currently drawing 0 and is looking to draw 1, and no way to deal with high main. Rough times for Dart.
Yeah, he can execute it. But in order to proc it, he has to use Inner Rage, which is what he was hoping to hold on to for Patron. And there is Patron. So next turn, he can start going for it. And I can imagine.
But he has to get through Misha first. And that's a way to get through Misha. But Dart's going to take a lot of damage. But this is the glimmer of hope that he was looking for.
Yeah. How does he go about this? He has to attack twice in the Misha?
It looks like he has to not only attack twice in the Misha, but he also has to Inner Rage execute the Savannah High main, which would mean he's going to take a lot of damage. No, actually, never mind. He doesn't have to do quite that. He can just do the Grim Patron and then use an Inner Rage Grim Patron and kill off the Savannah. Oh yeah. Boy, but Houndmaster.
Oh boy. That definitely puts a wrench in the plans. And Chalky is going in for the kill. Seeing it execute as well is a big deal. So now Dart has to... He would have to throw in both patrons or take the 8 damage swing. I think that just is game.
That's
and
right.
That is. And Dart chooses death, concedes, and Chalky puts himself on the board, finds a win with the Hunter, throws out the well played also. Dart knows that he definitely got pushed out of that game quickly.
Well, a much needed win from Chalky, and we've got Chalky with just an extra Freeze Mage now on top of Dart. Freeze Mage, great against Warlock, the Handlock, and then Freeze Mage has its chances against Patron.
Mm-hmm.
Still otherwise, a little even matchup.
Yeah, still a little bit of an uphill battle for Chalky. It can be a little daunting to be down in a series. And we're going to move into the next match. It is going to be the Zoo Warlock from Dart going up against Handlock from Chalky.
Oh, I guess I meant to say that Freeze Mage is good against you.
Yes. I would say so. Chalky, an okay hand. Owl lines up nicely with a lot of early creatures. Needs to get in, draw into one of those early threats, like Mountain Giant, Twilight Drake, if he wants to start fighting for board. Does pick up some stuff to play, at least.
Yep, start with a Knife Juggler into a Imp Gang boss. It's kind of sharp. Into Defender. Yeah.
Dart has a pretty scary hand. It feels like these decks are like getting closer to each other as time goes on. As Zeus starts to get more and more big threats, the curves of the decks start getting closer and closer to each other. It's pretty interesting.
It is. I have little doubts that someday the return of the lower curve Zoo will return.
The aggressive Zoo?
It'll be back. Not even necessarily aggressive, but just without the Dr. Boom.
Yeah. Maybe the old Scarlet Crusader, Argent Squire, Blood Knight Zoo will make a return as well. I think that was my favorite. Long ago.
Alright, pretty strong opening from Chalky. He has two Yetis on the defensive position.
This can be a little bit annoying for Dart to break through, but at least he can take solace in the fact that Chalky doesn't have many cards. He's has used one of his Taunt Givers. And we'll see if the Siphon Soul is going to be big for Chalky. That direct removal actually can be pretty good against the Demon Zoo now because of that high curve that we talked about. It can line up against things like Doomguard or Mal'Ganis even, which make it pretty good. And Dart's finding a way to navigate this where he's giving himself a pretty good opportunity to get some much-needed juggles. Face is not the place, unfortunately.
Nope, I like the ordering of that. It gave himself the maximum amount of chance to throw the juggle to kill the Ancient Watcher.
Chalky's got a couple options here. He can just play Sludge Belcher or Lotheb. He can, if he feels like his hand's not good enough, tap and Owl like the Imp Gang boss, but it's already got so much value that Owling at this stage doesn't feel that good. Sludge Belcher it is. Lots of big threats being drawn by Dart. Lotheb, Doomguard, and Dr. Boom in his hand right now.
That's right. Really Dart actually has a pretty good lineup against a pretty good Zoo tech against Chalky's lineup, since that Lotheb is so strong, and you don't always see it. It's strong against the Oil Rogue, it's strong against the Freeze Mage. Strong against Handlock even.
Yeah. Chalky finds the Sunfear Protector, which is gonna be pretty big later on in the match when he's able to play the Molten Giants. But the way the game is going, Dart might be able to set up a chance where he can just push through for one turn lethal with a Doomguard if he picks up some burn from the hand. Chalky really going to need to start picking up threats. With Lotheb on the board, he's not going to be able to play Siphon Soul, so he's going to have to trade in and hopefully tap into a creature that he can play that's actually a threat. Wow.
Hmm. Chalky would sure love Dart to hit him for 9.
And next to just Owldal and the Creeper? I would imagine since he doesn't have much of a board, he would try and go for something favorable, but ends up just going into the Loath up here.
Yeah, a good call in this case, because it could have otherwise been finished by Implosion.
Yeah.
I probably would have gone for the 3-2, but this turns out to be better.
Yeah, Implosion, Abuse of Sargon, both punish. Dr. Boom, pretty scary.
Yep, Chalky right now is in that zone where if Dart decides to push for it, Dart will lose the game. But there's so much power on the board that it's easy for Dart to like kind of navigate. In this case, though, the Boombots might work against him since Chalky picked up Mortal Coil. So Dart's got to be really careful with this next attack.
Ooh, how much damage is this? 5 on the board, 7 from hand. 12. He can't tap into lethal, so Power Woman would not give it to him. He'd be one off in that case. Actually, no.
Wait, on the lethal. Boombot, right. That would work.
Yeah. No, because he wouldn't have enough mana. Because he'd tap and he'd only have 6. Right. So just enough to play abusive. And there'd still be potential. Because he could Power Woman Abusive Sergeant. And the
Boombot. Oh my gosh, he's going to go for it with the Void Terror. This could be lethal. Let's see, what does he need? He needs
his Boombot hit for 7?
7, that's...
That's not 7. And all of a sudden, Chucky's in Molten Giant range.
Oh boy.
And not only does he have Molten Giants, but he has Molten Giant, Sun Fury, Dark Bomb.
At this point, he's like, oh, okay, he's at 11, might as well push him down to 8.
Yeah.
This is actually going to allow the Ragnaros, or... something else. No, it's not going to allow the Ragnaros, but it will...
Triple Giant Dark Bomb?
It's pretty sweet. Getting the Shadow Flame in would be also very nice.
Ooh. He'd have to Dark Bomb down the egg.
Right.
He can do that, though, but he'd have to Shadow Flame with his Moltons.
Molten Dark Bomb, Shadow Flame, Sun Fury, one giant. It does get rid of 15 attack from Dart's board. The other play is the simple giant, Sun Fury.
And most likely a Dark Bomb to try and take some more damage off the board here.
Yep.
And Dart's thinking, oh no. Where did it all go wrong? He did have an opportunity for lethal last turn, but it was a long shot. The Boombots had to hit for a total of 7 together, which is way above average.
Yep, that's one a 3 out of 16 chance.
Yeah. Well, there actually is... Ooh, he hits for 2. And that's probably going to be it. If it had hit for 3, he would have had a clear on 2 giants. He would have had to use his entire hand, nearly. It would have been there. And...
Chalky doesn't have it yet, though. Still no. And if Chalky doesn't have it, Dart actually can have it.
I think you just attack into the Void Caller, see Demon come out, Shadow Flame your mountain, and
right.
then go face. You pretty much have guaranteed lethal the next turn because you put him at 10. He's going to have to tap. And he's going to tap just to see here. Antique Healbot. Oh, man. Oh, Shadow Flame, Antique Healbot.
If it wasn't clear already.
Yeah. All right. Even with a Doomguard off the top, Ragnaros would end it. And probably going to concede here from Dart, as he's going to realize that this game is over and we have ourselves an even match. 2-2, it's tied up. Basically just going into 2 decks apiece for these guys. Which, it's getting close. Freeze Mage and Patron Warrior for Chalky. Zoo and Patron Warrior for Dart.
Dart does have that Lotheb tech, so the matchup of Zoo versus Mage got a lot closer. Patron versus Freeze Mage is a very interesting one as well. This is a matchup which some theorize is like you can absolutely say which side is going to win because most of the time it goes into fatigue. So both players drawing all their cards, but it does matter. What does matter quite a bit is the timing of the Emperor Thoris, and above all, I'd say.
Yeah, it's a really tough matchup. From the side of the Patron Warrior, you can almost play this like Control Warrior, where you're very conservative with your armorsmiths. You use your armor button a lot, and you get to the point where you just run the Freeze Mage out of damage, and eventually you'll fatigue them out or kill them. Because you do have removals to line up with their big threats most of the time, and you can sort of play it in that control mindset. But it can be a little bit tough if your removals don't line up, but it's a really intricate matchup.
It's one of the most intricate matchups in the game, that's for sure. In fact, there has already been an intricacy. Chalky chose the Fire Blast Dart on turn one. Of course, Chalky knows that Dart's playing Patron Warrior, and he knows that the plan is generally to armor up a lot, so Chalky's willing to deal the one damage to possibly enable more Battle Rage, but he's okay with it.
Yeah. Chalky not going to get the value that he kind of wanted out of that Acolyte of Pain, as Dart's going to coin out the Deathbite, and actually going to throw out the second Acolyte of Pain as well. So I talked about one of the ways that Patron Warriors can win this is by just armoring up and sort of fatiguing out the mage. Because they'll win but with the health advantage. And Chalky might realize this and realize that he doesn't really want to get too much card draw. He wants to sort of be ahead on the fatigue race and sort of just try and make it so he's going to be pushing ahead in that regard.
By, you know, here's something interesting too. Dart actually held the ultimate combo of Deathbite, Grim Patron, and Inner Rage, and he actually would have won the game if he had played it, but that doesn't mean it's good, because Chalky could easily have Blizzard, he could easily have Frost, Nova, Doomsayer, but it just turns out it was one of those games where Chalky had neither, and yeah, that would have just won.
Yeah. And Blizzard happens in waves. Like, first it deals the damage, and then it freezes. So what ends up happening is, if patrons are on the board, it actually freezes the new patrons that are spawned as well. Because the second wave happens after the damage is dealt. The freeze wave happens after the damage wave comes in.
Right, which makes it a really good setup for Blizzard into Flamestrike. But yeah, Chalky had neither.
Yeah. So Dart hasn't really fit in many armor-ups in this match so far.
Mm-hmm. Still plenty of game to go, though. It appears by not even humoring the Grim... Wow, that's a fast Thorison. By not humoring the Grim Patron early, his plan is going to be to utilize that Grim Patron along with the Armorsmith to gain a lot of armor. So Chalky, already the game plan from Dart kind of decided this early on.
Look at these cards that Chalky hit.
Oh my gosh, that's like the dream.
Chalky can Alexstrasza turn 8 and deal Pyroblast, Frostbolt, Ice Lance, not quite, because he won't be able to do that on turn 9. On turn 10, he could Pyroblast, Frostbolt, Ice Lance.
Which is this a total could be of a surprise win.
21 damage.
Never mind, not anymore. But yeah, that's a lot of damage. But even more traditionally, I suppose, and what will be the case here, is that Antonidas will get a lot of fireballs.
I think Chalky is going to have to Frostbolt this Armorsmith. And to be honest, Chalky might even Fireball it. Because it's less flexible of a card in combos.
Right, because the Frostbolt basically comes attached with a Fireball on it, in theory, if you're doing it, right?
It also procs Ice Lances, so it's 6 damage for 3 mana as opposed to what could be 11 damage for 1 mana.
Yep, that's painful, but it is correct, since the Armorsmith could easily have gained over 6.
And Chalky's going to count this, and all of a sudden he doesn't quite have enough damage. If he Alexstrasza's next turn, Dart should get 2 armor ups, which on the burst turn would put Dart above the range of Prior Blast, Frostbolt, Ice Lance, Ice Lance, which is 21 damage. Dart would be at 23, possibly even 25 health.
Dart with a surprising amount of damage coming up. The next turn, because he drew the Inner Rage, he has Warsong Commander, Grim Patron, Inner Rage, Death Spite, Whirlwind, which is a lot of damage. If he manages to draw the Flame Strike here, he actually just wins, I believe. And that looks like an obvious Flame Strike. Unfortunately for Dart, Chalky doesn't have Flame Strike and isn't able to make that quote-unquote error.
This is tough.
Yep. Dart has 26 on an empty board if he just goes Warsong, Grim Patron, Inner, I believe. 22, 26, yes. Oh, boy. Does he have it? He does have it. Dart wins. He just has to sacrifice everything to Alex. Oh, sorry. That's one short.
Well, Dart thinks he has it. I think this is it. So he's going to have 4 from Deathbite plus 10 from Grim Patrons plus the extra...
Oh, sorry. Did I say 24? I said it was 26. Never mind. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah, it is it. All right. And Chalky went with what he thought was best line of play here, but he is going to fall in.
Surprise!
Yeah, sort of the nature of the matchup, and Chalky just not drawing into his AoE here is a really big deal against Patron Warrior. And
probably not so much that, as he didn't find an opportunity to play Ice Block? It's kind of hard to say. Like, that's a really surprising turn for this game to end.
Yeah, I mean, that turn, even if he had played Ice Block, Dart would have put him at 1. So he could have popped the Ice Block at 1 health. It would have been tough to deal that extra 1 damage, but it is going to come down to Dart just having to find a win with the Zoo Warlock. He's got 2 opportunities. He has to beat either Freeze Mage or Patron Warrior. So that's... Freeze Mage is generally pretty decent against the Zoo, but Patron Warrior can sometimes struggle.
Yeah, but again, Dart does have the Lilithev in the Zoo, so that makes the Freeze Mage matchup better, and it also makes the Patron Warrior matchup better, since sometimes you have all the stuff out and a Whirlwind would ruin your day, but you just toss on the Lilithev and lock them out. We begin with a pretty good early 1-2 from Dart.
And Chalky's hand is not the best at the moment. No early cards to play. He's going to have to ping this Flame Imp over 2 turns, which is never what you want to see. You always want to get that Mad Scientist or even like a Loot Hoarder early on to contest the board. And Dart's got... He's lusting for blood right now.
You're right.
He's definitely
it's not
got
great,
the victory in his sights.
On the other hand, from Chalky land, if he does Fire Blast here, the Zoo is only representing 1 damage against you. So what the Zoo is looking for, similar to what Zoo looks for against Patron Warrior, is the early aggression. And with that buff, he still only has 6 damage worth of stuff. But it's getting there, and it's very sticky.
Yeah. Almost impossible for Chalky to remove efficiently. And Chalky's going to need some AoE. He's going to need the Frost Nova Doomslayer into AoE because, like you said, the board is sticky. Even with a board clear, he's still in a spot where if he took off all the creatures right now, he'd still be left with 6 power on the board with a Nerubian and 2 of the 1-1s. And now Chalky's going to be afraid to sort of proc this Void Caller as well for the possibility of what's on the other side of it. As Dart did play that really quickly. And Chalky does get the Ice Burst. That's going to buy him some time.
Yeah, if there's one thing Chalky has going for him, it's time. Dart's board is somewhat weak. Only 8 attack. I mean, it built up quite a bit. Chalky going for a quick Thor Sand. That's probably going to get traded into. Like, on the one hand, Dart doesn't want to trade into it because it makes his board a lot less sticky. On the other hand, owling it isn't really an option because it really needs to be saved for Doomsayer. The Abusive Sergeant is a nice pickup to be able to kill it more efficiently. Or hope for the 3. The 4. Great.
Yeah, and Defender Vargas is going to trade into it, thus keeping his board still resistant to the AoE. Ooh. That could be interesting. Antoninus, I believe this is only the second time we've seen Antoninus today from Chalky's Freeze Mage. It feels like he's struggled the most to find wins with the Freeze Mage, as it has lost, I believe, 4 games so far in the 2 best of 5s that he's played.
Yep, tough board to deal with. It's just going to stick around so much. And Chalky decides to go for this line first. It is going to get owled. Oh, okay, no Doomsayer.
I think he can fill up the board to make its next turn by killing off the Haunted Creeper with the Blizzard, so that way Owl can't come out when he plays Doomsayer.
But the Imps all die, so that's going to leave a lot of space.
Oh, that's true. Dart. Big creatures are tougher for the Freeze Mage to deal with, so if he plops out the Void Terror here, he can pull out a Imp Gang Boss. He can't play the Void Walker first because he doesn't have enough room on the board to play the Void Caller when that's the case. And he does pull out the Imp Gang Boss, so.
Good result for him. Continues to save the Owl and an empty space on the board for the Doomsayer. Again, with this very sticky board, and Dart had paid close. Like, he could have eaten the egg, but that weakens his board against the AoE, so that's a good call. Just really a nightmare for Chalky to get past this death rattle stuff.
Yeah. Chalky can clear the board here, except for the Nerubian and the Imps.
Yeah, except this stuff.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he can clear off the important stuff. Like the Void Terror. So, in the end, it's really just the Nerubian that's left. Because next turn, he'll be able to just ping off the extra 1-1s. And at the end of the day, it's really only the Nerubian that's left as a threat. So, he is going to get... should get a couple more draws at least.
When all that stuff came out, it looked like, wow, that's a lot of stuff. But... you did manage to deal with it pretty elegantly.
Yeah, almost really cards, not a though, lot.
Which is the problem.
He does have a couple of draws like on the board.
That's true.
So by next turn, he could draw as many as 4 cards, depending on how many times his acolyte's able to get in. But it looks like it is going to be denied at least 1 draw. There's a double anti-Healbot in the Freeze Mage from Chalky. So double Ice Barrier, double Healbot.
Wow, clearly positioning it against the more aggressive metagame. Sometimes you don't even see one Healbot in these decks. 2 is astounding.
The fireball doesn't do much.
And the blizzard makes a 4-4 pop out. But looks like you have to do some triage here. If there's any thing that makes Chalky feel good, though, it's that the opponent is nearly out of cards.
And he has double Healbot still. Oh, Lotheb. I guess double Healbot is what you want to have in your hand when Lotheb comes out on the board, so...
That's going to be a strong play, yeah.
He is going to stay alive.
In Dart's perspective, the Lotheb is going to be so good right now because it locks out a lot of things. He is going to want to play the Owl, and yeah, he is definitely going to want to play the Lotheb with that since it protects so many things. Interestingly enough, it hits nothing from Chalky. Almost nothing. But in a way, that speaks volumes to how much trouble Chalky is in, that he didn't have a solution anyways, if there wasn't a Lotheb. Mm-hmm.
And one Healbot he feels is going to be enough, because you need to get this Mad Scientist on the board to try and draw out either the second Ice Block or the second Ice Barrier, which is going to represent a lot of heal as we move forward. Mal'Ganis is pretty big, but right now there's no demons on the board. And Chalky does have a way to deal with the Mal'Ganis. I wouldn't be surprised if Dart just throws it down.
Yep, makes sense. Along with the Voidwalker. It's a nice buff. Yeah. Toss Dingo.
So this one is probably going to come down to the wire. Dart has tapped a lot, and eventually he will get into range of some big stuff. Okay, he decides to tap. He realizes he's going to have to save Mal'Ganis for when, like, inevitable lethal's coming for the next turn.
Yep, that's so close. He only needed to tap into a tiny bit of damage there. Wow. He's going to fill her up. Does that mean he's going to try to trade down some of this stuff?
Oh, man, he could put him at one.
He's got to be so scared of that Flame Strike. He does, do a little bit of trading. Chalky in the bad spot of no AoE. He mounts over his... Well, we saw that there's 12 cards left in Chalky's deck, a lot of which is Area of Effect.
Chalky has used any Flame Strike
if he's got two Healbots.
No, we've seen double Flame Strike.
Okay, we have. Alright.
Yeah. So...
Then I have to imagine drawing for that to be really strong. Oh, never mind. He's calculated that he has a most likely lethal coming up. Wow, this is a bold play.
Very bold indeed. Oh, man. I don't think that juggle was what he wanted. Can he still get through the ice barrier, pop the block, and kill Antonitis? So he's got 6, plus 8, 14, 17, 22 damage. And he needs to get through 12 or 13 plus 7.
Yep.
Which is
20. Looks like it should work, but of course, what he's calculating is getting him as low as possible.
Yeah.
And that's a little bit of a puzzle. I'm really surprised at the Archmage draw. What could he have drawn to do 17 anyways? With Fireball, Frostball, Fireball, that's 15. Maybe he was just drawing for the other Ice Block. Oh, was that? No, there's a...
So... This is really tough.
That it is.
The only way for Chalky to survive here is to anti-Killbot and Frost Nova. If he does that,
right,
he can Ice Lance and Frostbolt the Mal'Ganis to kill it.
That looks pretty good. And then he's got the 15 in hand with Fireball, Fireball, Frostbolt. So if Anti-Killbot manages to connect, but there is that 1-3 Voidwalker after Mal'Ganis is dead.
Shaki may not expect the Doomguard, though. And if he doesn't play Healbot here, Doomguard is going to be it. And it looks like he's actually going to go for Burn. And it looks like Dart is going to take the game.
Oh, that was the right and play. The series. He set up Lethal for the next turn. All right. Dart is overjoyed.
He's going to savor the moment.
Really, Dart? What a showman.
I think that was a bit unnecessary. Oh! Jackie, a little bit upset at that one as well. And Dart, a little bit of BM at the end. He's going to take it, and Dart will be the eighth and final player to move to the grand finals at PAX, joining Kalento, Pavel, Trump, Hoy, Tom, Wafster, and Nostim. The eight is set. Those players will compete for $25,000 and 230 world championship points.
Yeah, big congratulations to Dart. I will see you on the battlefield.
Well, this is the guy that you said you'd be happier to face at the end of the day, as the grand tournament will be out, and Chucky has proven himself time and time again after his victories in the race for Black Rock Mountain to be an innovator in the field of competitive Hearthstone players. But Chucky will not go away empty-handed. $1,500 still to him. Of course, there was Geico points on the line, but Chucky was not in any position to pass anyone with the 16 Geico points that he would gain. So $1,500, still a lot, though. Chucky can't be too disappointed with his performance. He still played pretty well. And at the end of the day, that Freeze Mage play, if Dart did not have the Doomguard, it would have been setting up for the winning play with the Fireball, Fireball, Frostbolt, or Fireball, Fireball, Ping. So definitely well played by Chucky throughout the weekend.
And good for Dart. He actually was one of the players who took advantage of the format of this entire series. He was invited into this one because he had the most Geico points and hadn't already been in a feature tournament, so he manages to basically grind out those open tournaments and get his spot, and now he's moving on to PAX. Way to work for it, Dart.
Yeah, and this is the breakout performance that he was sort of looking for, especially since, as you mentioned, now if he places highly at PAX, he has a chance to get into that top eight, which is the sweet spot, gives you a bye in those first couple rounds of the BlizzCon regionals for North America. So definitely a big congratulations to him. Another reminder, guys, make sure you head over to geico.onog.gg. We're still giving away an official TSM PC, and I believe that giveaway will still be going on all the way through the grand finals, if I'm not mistaken. Also, once again, a big shout out to Geico for making it possible for us to put on these shows. We had 8 qualifiers from each region, so a total of 16, 4 feature tournaments. That's like 26 days of broadcasting going on, lots of Hearthstone action, and wouldn't have been possible without them. But I think that is going to do it for us. Trump, it's been a pleasure casting with you throughout the weekend. Do you have any final words, any shout-outs that you'd like to give before we close it out and send it off?
Sure, I guess I'll say, this is how I feel about how the tournament went. Yay!
Oh, man, I didn't even see that shirt. That's pretty awesome. Well, once again, thank you, Trump. And from myself, from Trump, from One Nation of Gamers, from Geico, from Team Liquid, and TSM, all the partners, thank you guys for watching. And be sure to tune in to the grand finals at PAX August 28th through 30th. We'll make sure to see you there. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next time.